Help me with what?
If you need food, whatever. But if you guys are doing drugs and you involve my kids, because my kids are around, our friends are around, it's odd behavior. You guys are doing odd behavior, whatever you do.
You say we're doing odd behavior?
It's odd behavior. You want to be part of the community? That's fine.
How is it odd behavior, though?
You're hanging out at his house, outside the house, for who knows how long.
Wait, what? Okay,
so what are you, how?
I was just inside. Drugs? I don't even do drugs.
Look.
What?
Just be clean. Just be honest. stay away from the kids, okay?
Look, sir, I don't do drugs.
I don't smoke or anything. I don't care. It's not my business. But stay away from the kids. That's all I ask. Okay?
Okay.
Okay? We good?
All right, whatever, man.
My respect, though, okay?
All right, whatever.
Mayor, you know what is odd? What's odd is walking across the street in your neighborhood and accosting a kid who just came outside, who was just there, we learned, visiting relatives. We're calling this a holiday mail, Karen. He mentioned drugs. Odd behavior, Mayor, was just coming outside. Excuse of drug use.
The tragedy of all of this, Sister Reed, is did you hear his analogy? He starts off talking about you're doing drugs, my kids are here, other kids are here, your odd behavior. And he said you've been outside for a long time. That implies that you've been watching this kid for a long time. The odd behavior, of course, is being outside. Really what he said is the odd behavior is having your black skin across the street from my house. Then he tried to walk away and say, oh, if you're doing drugs, it's not my business. If it's not your business, why are you on this side of the street? This is definition. This is whiteness. How you come in hot and then back off and try to be victim. Oh, it's not my business. He threw his hand up. It's not my business. I don't care. I don't care. I don't care. If we don't care, why are you over lecturing me about being black outside? We know what the crime is. The crime is he's black on a skateboard. Period.
That's right. And Mayor, I want to caution you to calm down too. Okay, yeah. You need to calm down. Okay, okay. I need to see your papers. But by the way, calm down. You're scaring me. You're very aggressive, okay? And my kids are here. You're aggressive, okay? Let's tell you more. The gentleman, and really the kid who was accosted here is a gentleman, okay? This guy did not deserve it. Did not even deserve the conversation. Skate Lord Be Chill, the black skater who recorded this, uploaded it to TikTok. Just a couple days ago, mentions in the caption, he was just visiting family in Tucson, Arizona. What a great first impression. Again, Mayor, this is how stuff gets out of hand. This is how people die. You mentioned something that I didn't hear when I first saw this. I was stunned. I was shocked. And it's hard to be shocked by a Karen or a male Karen these days. But I was pretty shocked when I saw this one. It looked like an SNL skit or that, you know, website Funny or Die. Okay, I thought that I said, you know, hey, Alex, you gotta check the source on this because this might be a comedy sketch. This does not seem real. It is real. But you seized upon something. He said, been outside for a while. Yeah, he was stalking him. Okay, I know a kid who just had Skittles and a Snapple who is no longer with us. He was stalked too. So the way this gentleman, Skate Lord Be Chill, behaved, I don't think it's a stretch. It could have saved his life, Mayor.
No, I mean, let's be honest. I mean, we're talking about someone who's displaying behaviors that is racist. I mean, this is profiling. You're not a police officer, but you're still profiling this child. And that's, you're talking about your children not caring about somebody else's child in your very action. This is hypocrisy on high. However, in America, when you're talking about black suffering or black traumatic experiences, it does not apply. It does not apply. This is how we can say all men are created equal and still own black men and black women, right? This is the very nature, going back to what I said earlier. This is as American as apple pie and baseball. We cannot pretend that this racist behavior that exists in what we just saw is a small thing. And when we say it's a small thing, we minimize what could have happened had that young man said, hey, you're oppressing, you're coming close to me, and picked up his skateboard like he was gonna do something. It's Arizona, home of the neo-Nazis. He could have been shot. We don't know what could have happened had this kid chose a different path or did everything he had the right to do and be angry at this man for accosting him. So I think You're absolutely right. His behavior, this young man's behavior, probably saved his life. His life, or prevented the cops from being called. And we know young men of his age, between 18 and 24, this is one of the leading calls, if not the leading calls, for black men, death by cop. So this is not a small thing. We shouldn't pretend that it is. So I think this is absolutely disgusting.
Yeah, it is. And I gotta tell you, I don't think there's enough outrage. You know, not a lot of comments here. This is why TYT is here. This is why Indisputable exists, to shine a light on this kind of filth. You know, when this male Karen came across the street and started spewing his hatred, I thought he was quoting, you know, that guy who came down the escalator and declared his candidacy for the presidency. But today he woke up believing what he believes.